Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning channel. In part 2 of using the Image Timeline FX for grading and look development, you learned how to apply different shaders other than the master grade to a selective. This included applying, mixing, and rearranging multiple shaders within the selective. Finally, for organizational purposes, you learned how to name selectives and move or copy them around the Image Timeline FX processing pipeline to better suit your working styles. Now, this has all been done within one Image Timeline FX within a single segment. In this video, we start looking at the bigger context of the edit and start copying selectives between shots and creating a consistent look development across the sequence. If you would like to follow along, please go to part 1 and start from there. So to set the context, you're in the effects environment and you're currently working within the first segment. Looking at the storyboard reel, the selected thumbnail has the Image Timeline effects applied to it. You can also see this if you look at the effects pipeline underneath the storyboard reel. Segment 2 and segment 3 of the edit currently have nothing applied. Now, as a quick recap, if you wanted to copy the entire Image Timeline effects to the other segments, you multi-select the thumbnails in the storyboard reel and drag the Image Timeline effects to the secondary selection. As a tip, you can also drag the timeline effects from the effects pipeline. So all the segments in the sequence have the exact same Image Timeline effects as segment 1, and the grading appears to be consistent. Now, I would say that this is great for most situations. However, in the previous videos, we applied some very specific selectives to the first image. You have the overall grade on selective 1, but you have secondaries on selective 2 and branding removal on selective 5. Moving to the next shot, you won't want the original secondaries, because this is a completely different shot. And there is also no need for the selective with branding removal. The third shot is from the same camera, but you don't have any branding to hide. The secondaries, on the other hand, will need to be repurposed since the talent has moved around the frame. So copying the entire Image Timeline FX might be a bit of an overkill in this case. Instead, you can copy specific selectives to certain shots instead of the whole Image Timeline FX. So press Undo or Ctrl Z to undo the Timeline FX copy. In order to copy a specific selective, ensure you select it in the Viewport HUD or Selective Manager. Now, using the Selective Manager, all you need to do is pick up the selective and drag it to a thumbnail or a multi-selection of thumbnails in the storyboard reel. An Image Timeline FX is created on the receiving segment, and only the specific selective is copied. Looking at the HUD of this shot, you can see that you only copied selective 1. So you don't lose any time by having to delete unnecessary selectives off this segment. Now, you can also copy multiple selectives using the same workflow. Looking at the third shot, you'll reuse the primary and secondary grades. So go back to the first segment and multi-select selective 1 and selective 2 using Control. You don't need selective 5, as there is no branding to blur out. Next, drag the selectives to segment 3 and both selectives will be applied to the shot. The thumbnail updates, and if you select the thumbnail to bring up the segment's timeline effects, you will see that only selective 1 and selective 2 have been copied in this case. Now, what is very important to remember is that by default, when you copy a selective or multiple selectives to another shot, the selective numbering is copied as well. So in this case, selective 1 and 2 in the first shot have been copied to selective 1 and 2 in the third shot. This is quite obvious when you look at the Selective Manager for the different shots. If something already existed in Selective 1 and 2 of the third shot, the copy would overwrite the old Selective settings. If you wanted to keep the original Selectives in the third segment and append any Selective you copy, just hold Shift when you drag the Selective, and this will append the Selectives to the next available slots in the Selective Manager. So you can either overwrite or add to the existing Selectives when copying. Now looking at the third shot, the masks in Selective 2 need to be realigned on the faces of the talent. So ensure that Selective 2 is selected and choose the axis of this mask. There is no animation associated with this mask, so it should be easy to realign the mask to his face, and this should be fine throughout the shot. When you scrub the time bar, this mask combined with the keyer works fine for the whole shot. However, the second mask is animated and is nowhere near the talent. So pan the image over to the right and scrub to the middle of the time bar to see the talent's face. Select the axis of the G mask and click the reset button to remove its animation. Next, move the mask over the talent's face and reshape the mask to fit his face and neck. Now this also needs to be tracked to his movement, so select the axis, and this time you'll do a point track using track mode. Enter the tracker. To prevent the mask from shifting after the track, change the tool's pull-down menu to offset reference. Move the reference over his face. Analyze forward, and then analyze backward to include the earlier frames. When you exit the tracker, the mask should stick very well to his face. If you select Secondary Selective 2 and switch to the Selective Matte View with F8, you will see that the mask combined with the keyer is enough to isolate the face correctly. Press F4 to return to the result view. Now looking at the entire edit, all the shots use the same primary grade. The first and third shot use the same secondary. However, their masks are different to match the talent in each shot. Now a very common scenario is that you need to update the secondaries. So on the current selection, you use the Gain Color wheel and add a bit more red to their faces. So the secondaries now differ between shot 3 and shot 1. In order to make them match, you need to copy Selective 2 from the third segment to the first segment. If you just drag Selective 2 to the first thumbnail, it will overwrite the original Selective, but it will also overwrite the masks and keyer in the Selective. All you want to do is update the shaders and not the constraints of the Selective. So undo this operation if you copied the Selective. This time, hold space and drag the Selective to the first segment. This will only copy the Selective effect shaders and not the Selective constraints. So looking at the first segment and choosing Selective 2, the masks and key are still the same, but the master grade now has the red adjustment which matches the other shots. So space and drag only copies the Selective effects of the Selective and not the Selective keyer or mask. If you wanted the inverse of that, Alt and drag copies the Selective keyer and masks and not the Selective shaders. All these Selective copy operations will work for individual shots as well as a multi-selection of shots. As a final tip, for artists who prefer using a node graph for Selective copying and interaction instead of the gestural operations of the storyboard reel, you do have access to the image schematic, where you can copy and paste objects, as well as perform some more advanced operations using the Image TimelineFX. More functionality will be covered in future videos. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to Flame 2019. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.